In over 26 years working at the Blue Hill Observatory and Science Center in Milton, Massachusetts, Operations Director Don McCaslin has learned a thing or two.
This trunk is a beech or a birch.
About a thing or two.
A pebble this big here will become a grain this big at the bottom of the stream.
Some of which he shares daily with students getting back to nature.
We've created a program called Nature's Record to see how the weather impacts vegetation. Today is a guided hike where the students get to see different parts of Blue Hill, including a vernal stream, a tree growing on the side of a rock, and how vegetation can adapt based on the weather.
At the top of Great Blue Hill, students visit the oldest continually operating weather observatory in the United States.
We opened on February 1st, 1885. We study and measure the weather the exact same way today as has been done for the past 140 years. Plus, we have all the modern tools and techniques for measuring the weather.
This is also the place where McCaslin connects with the sky in a very different way.
It started with my brother when he was in college. He was all stressed out. He went to the local store, bought a kite, and he enjoyed it so much that when he came home on spring break, he said, "Let's go fly a kite." And I fell in love with it and been doing it ever since.
Despite decades of experience, he can still fall victim to the occasional nosedive. But he says he's never discouraged.
Literally tied to the sky. You're feeling the power of the wind. You're looking up at the sky, enjoying the beauty of the clouds, and it's a different perspective and definitely makes you feel good about the world around you.
For the past 44 years, McCaslin has been an active member of CONE, or Kites Over New England.
We have kite flying for novices and experts and everything in between. The support among the kite flying community is tremendous. You go to any kite flying event, find somebody who looks like they know what they're doing and ask them for help. They are going to help you.
Where once go fly a kite was seen as a dismissive jab, McCaslin sees it differently.
I said, thank you, that's a great idea.
Oh, well, it's not a surprise. McCaslin used to own a kite shop, Kites of Boston. It was in Faneuil Hall for 12 years.
Yeah, and coming to the observatory was a bit of a homecoming, if you will, for Don, because his father actually used to work there. And it's also where his parents met. So without the observatory, there's no Don at all, as it turns out. They do have a gift shop there. And yes, kites are generally in stock.